Hey guys, Harsh here from Shout Me Loud, and welcome to another video episode. And today video is about WordPress. This is for all the WordPress users, and what we're going to learn today is how to update your WordPress plugin the right way. So WordPress is doing a great job with the WordPress updates. Now they automatically update your WordPress blog when they launch a major update, which is pretty good and make it easier for, you know, all the WordPress users. But this is not the same case with the plugin. For the plugins, you need to update it manually. And what happened is sometime when people update plugins, their WordPress blog stop working. I mean, it might break down and things happen. Not all the time, but sometime it happens. So I'm sharing one tip that you can use when you're updating a plugin, and this would really help you in longer run. So here is how it works. When you log into WordPress dashboard, click on updates at the top or here. And here you can see what all updates are available. Okay, usually what people do, like they select all the available updates, click on update plugins. And what happens that the things break. And why it breaks that, because sometimes if you have not developed your WordPress blog by yourself, you have hired a developer, you're using some custom code, those functionalities stop working after updating the plugin. So number one, when you're updating a plugin, ensure, is it really important to update? So what you can do, click on view version. So right now I'm using this Easy Digital Download plugin. I'm using this particular version. They have 2.4.9. So they have released two updates. Here I can see what all updates, changes they have made. It's a good idea that you go through the change log and see what updates have been done. That way you would know, like, is it really important or crucial for you to update the plugin or not? So in this case, this one is not so important. This one is again not important in my case, so I'll skip this one. This one seems important because they have added few new things, few fixes. And so, you know, the whole idea is you need to go through the change log. And similarly for this plugin, I'll go through minor CSS change, not important. They have added support for custom post type. That's pretty good, but still I'm not going to update this because I'm afraid that certain functionality would break. Usually if there is a major security update or an update that is very crucial, you would see in the change log, that's where you should update the plugin. And if you're sure that, you know, certain plugins like Akisma, Jetpack, where when you update the plugin, your theme or your blog would not break, you can update it right away. And before you update the plugin, it's always a good idea that you take a backup of your database. This is one mistake most of the WordPress blogger make, and later on they have to face a lot of challenges in terms of fixing their blog. So pretty much that's it. And if you have any question regarding updating WordPress plugin or anything related to WordPress, do let me know. If you want me to do another video on WordPress on any particular topic, you can suggest me in the comment section. I'll see you in the next video. If you like this video, do like and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.